I did it on purpose.
Now, this guy, I'm out playing with him one day on number 17. He's only 10 yards from the green. Yes, it is almost. And the ball goes over the green. He goes back there and he gets it again. Boom, back over this side. I thought I was watching a tennis match.
I was playing with you in the club championship on number 12.
Yeah.
When you four putted from the line. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'm 17. He's only 10 feet from the hole. I couldn't take it anymore. Anyway, I said, I can't take it anymore. I put a ball down and said, listen, Mickey, for crying out loud, just take the wedge up and let it fall on the ball. What happened? You remember?
It went in.
True. But you must have had a magnet in that ball.
Stand up, will you?
I'll go for
it. I just want to
Danny.
Say no. That we don't have anything in common. Let me show
you. Eddie's always been a great golfer. And sometimes he thinks he's better than he is. So, well, if you think you're better, you get a big head. I think Eddie's got the biggest head in the world.
Let's find out.
Sorry, now speak loud. Tina!
What?
I'm sitting with your hubby, you know, and Dirk was with us, and Dirk says, what the hell's that green spot up here? I said, well, the damn glass is the brass on there is turning my head green. And Andy says, oh no, at your age, that's mold. Now he's in the teens. I have never seen anything like that in my life. Anybody improved that much. Congratulations, Greg. Del Castro. Del Castro's at number 8 on the green. I'm here. He's way over there. He's back on the green. And he puts, he's putting 20 feet to the right, and he's yelling, go in, go in. And he hit a goose turd, and he thought it was a goose turd. True story.
Oh my God.
said, did you play yesterday? I said, yes. Who with? Seabert News. Well, he says, I saw Seabert News on the green. I didn't see you. I said, I was a couple holes ahead of him.
Here. I'm not as old as Eddie, but I can still, I can see that number. But I want, you know, those senior moments to hit. But anyway, I remember when they start calling Eddie Fast Eddie, and I knew why after they start calling him that. But I don't know why they call him Half Fast Eddie. What they should call him is Twice as Fast Eddie. You know, we're out there as a foursome, we're playing, and Eddie's always way ahead of us. And we're saying, you know what? It won't be long. We'll be as a threesome. And this is a true story. I'm going to tell you this about Eddie. And this is when he was younger, like maybe 86. We're on number one tee box. And I look at him and I say, Eddie, I'll bet you $10 you got a pair of shoes just like that at home. And he looks at me dumbfounded and he says, what the hell are you talking about? He looks down, he had two different shoes on. I told this joke to Eddie several months ago, and I know he told me three or four times,
so
Joe,
funny.
At my party, you got to tell this joke. So I'm going to tell it, but blame it on Eddie.
Yeah.
The four possible foursomes you could have in golf are four people. Stormy Daniels.
Oh, yes.
O.J. Simpson. Ted Kennedy. And Donald Trump. Stormy Daniels, she's a hooker. O.J. Simpson, he's a slicer. Ted Kennedy can't get it over the water. And Donald Trump never knows what hole he's on. You know, it wasn't too long ago, Eddie and I, we used to play with the so-called A-team. And, you know, when the round was over, whoever won the money put all the money on the table. Then we all go up there and have a few drinks. And, you know, it seemed like the losers always drank more. And the winners, hopefully, they could take a couple of bucks home. But anyway, what am I going to say?
He's running out of time.
Oh yeah, here it comes.
You call me over.
Like I said, I can see your number. Eddie, you know, after playing golf one of those days when after with the 18, Eddie says, you know what? I can't come up there today. I got to go to the store. Earlene wants me to pick up a couple things. So Eddie left. As he's coming out of the store, this scruffy, dirty, homeless guy approaches him, never shaved in probably 5 or 6 years. And he says, sir, do you have a couple bucks so I can get a hamburger? Eddie said, no. He said, but I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll give you 10 bucks, and you can buy a 6-pack of beer. The guy looks at Eddie and says, no, thank you, sir. He says, I quit drinking a long time ago. So Eddie thought a minute, and he says, I'll tell you what, I'll give you 20 bucks, and I'll take you down to the local golf course and let you play around the golf. The guy says, no, thank you, sir.
I quit playing golf a long time ago. So Eddie thought about that for a few minutes. He says, you know what I'm going to do, buddy? He said, I'm going to take you home, have my wife cook you the best meal you ever had, let you take a shower and shave, and I'm going to give you a clean change of clothes. The guy looks up at Eddie and says, sir, don't you think your wife will be upset with you taking me home? He said, that's okay. I just want to let her see what someone looks like when they quit drinking and playing golf.
A match with a pro. What happened, Scotty? Get up, stand up, and tell us that story.
It's pretty good.
Right.
Oh, okay.
Where? Larry Stiles, wherever you are. Thank you for your service, helicopter man in Vietnam. Thank you.
Brady Couples was going to play Billy Riggs, you know, that tennis star. And Riggs said, I'll play you straight up, but I get one throw, a hold. Brady Couples said, well, I can still beat him, you know. They both hit their tee shots. Billy Riggs goes out there and he picks up Brady's ball and throws it out of bounds. Brady always said, know your best. Know your bet. This guy, I think just about all of you know Dick Morales. The two of them were having lunch. A couple of tables over there, some lady stood up and she's drunken. Dick Morales runs over there and he threw her dress up and dropped her pants and he licked her across the butt. We come back to the table, Eddie said, that's amazing. He says, I didn't know that Heimlich maneuver would work.
I just want to take a minute to remember a couple of people who was not here tonight. Spud Cooney, Junior Cusapachi, and Jerry Dillon. Now, Jerry Dillon loved the comedian Jonathan Winters.
Oh, yeah.
Every time we have a costume party, he dressed up as Ma Frickin.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ma Frickin. Now, Gino had a little temper. We're out playing 14 holes. He's my partner for 13 holes. He hasn't hit one golf ball all over the place. He hits it in the woods in 14, and he goes ballistic, throws his club, you son of a bee. He said, I ought to take a gun to my head and shoot myself. And I said, Gino, you play so bad, you probably miss. True story. In the clubhouse, you know. Oh, Eddie, come have a glass of wine. Tell me about O'Brien. Come on, I had to tell him this joke every time I met him. It's an old joke, so I'll tell it anyway. Five Cody said, tell me about O'Brien. O'Brien goes into a bar, and he's all beat up. The bartender says, what happened, O'Brien? He says, Murphy hit me. What did he have in his hand? A steel pipe. What did you have in your hand? Mrs. Murphy's ass. A thing of beauty it is, but not much of a weapon.
He's killing him.
Forget anybody. My grandchild wanted to play a tune club with you.
Oh, yeah. Chris wants to play.
Everybody.
Christian, where are you?
He's over there right now.
Oh, okay, do you need the mic?
Well, he should be in the center. Oh.
This is one of my favorites.
Who was that? Not me.
No?
No.
Neil McDowell.
No, Neil.
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 Neil. You want to say something? Come on up here.
It's Neil's birthday.
Neil up there.
Yeah, oh, man. There, there. Hey. Yeah, she was in it the whole time.
Oh my god, I was so beaten. I bring over my cake at home. Just playing with my cake.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
No, it sounds great.
Sounded great.
Quite a bit older than all of us here. And he comes up and tells about the same joke at least once.
Right.
Once a night. And so I'm going to, there's a lot of people here who haven't heard this one, but a lot of you have. So Eddie and I were out playing golf one day, and we were on number 10, and he hit his ball into the edge of the water and rolled in among the reeds that are along the hole number 10. He walks up to the edge of the pond and looking for his ball, and he hears this sound. Help me. Help me. And so he digs around in the tulies, and there's a frog. And the frog's looking up at him and says, help me. If you will take me out of this pond, turn me over and rub my belly three times, I'll give you the best, I'll turn into a beautiful, beautiful lady and give you the best sex you've ever had in all of your life.
Yeah.
And he looks down, puts the frog in his pocket, drops the ball, knocks it up on the green. It's his turn to putt, and he bends over to putt. And you know how hard it is to line up a putt anyway. But when you got a frog in your pocket saying, help me, it makes it even harder. So Eddie takes the frog out of his pocket and he says, listen, I heard you when I first saw you and you told me that you would give me the best sex I ever had in my life. And I heard you again right now tell me that you could turn into a beautiful lady and give me the best sex that I ever had in my life. But I want you to know, at my age, I'd rather have a talking frog.
This young man, unfortunately had a wooden eye. He was very self-conscious. His friends tried to get him to go to a dance, and he finally got him there. And he's standing on the corner. Yeah, nobody would dance with me. I got a wooden eye. So he sees a girl way in the corner over there. He says, she's got a hair lip. Maybe she'll dance with me. So he goes over there and he says, would you like to dance? She says, wouldn't I? And he says, hair lip.
They had the Spanish Bay just opened up in down in Monterey. So I had a couple other guys and Ed, we went down there first, we had a chance. We get down there, we go through, we put our shoes on. Ed's got two left shoes. Now that's true, that's true. The other shoe story I got is that we were playing the 11th hole at Santa Clara, and Ed's behind me and he says, Ledmeyer, you've got two wrong shoes on. And I said, what are you talking about? So we got, you know, I said, okay, well, we'll fix it when we get done. So it winds up that we split shoes for about a month. And he says, geez, one of my foot was hurting. I was fine with one of his shoes. You know, to be in his life, I mean, it was just, there's so many unbelievable things that happen on the planet. You know, he's just a beautiful person and a beautiful family. Let's see, what the hell's, oh, the first time that we ever got together, I was running the golf tournaments for the school. So I get this call, what's this golf tournament all about? You know, what kind of players are out there? Okay, how do you play? What do you want to do? Okay, Ed. I'll play with you. Well, let me think about it. Okay, so he called me back the next day, and he says, okay, I'll play with you. But that's Ed. You know, you gotta respect that. Well, there's many other stories, but I can't think of them right now. But thank you for a lifetime of stories and friendship. And I mean, we played a lot of golf together, almost
45 years.
I'd go over and pick him up, and Saturdays we'd go play someplace. So, but he also almost won the what the heck was that down there? Down in Spyglass. To Pasadena, he was a player down there in Pasadena, and only Ed can do this. He's got the guy down going into the 18th hole, and he hits a super iron shot, and he backs it off the green down into the garbage, loses the hole, and then he lost in overtime. But that's, remember that?
No, I don't want to remember.
The other thing we did, Ed had a partner from down there, and he's playing in Palo Alto Hills, and Palo Alto Hills Invitational. So I know Ed's going to win this tournament. I know he's going to win it, because he's got the same bagger coming from that other golf course. So I went around and I got money from all the rest of our friends. I said, come on, this is a sure thing. Ed's going to win this. And he did. And then when the payoff came, Earlene saying, they didn't get hardly any money.
Yeah, that's funny.
Yeah, because we got it, right? Okay, well, thanks a lot.
Hey, we got telegrams. We got telegrams. Well, we're going to read them. There's about 8.
Oh, good.
But anybody younger than Dennis Dookie doesn't know what a telegram is.
Hey, I do.
All right. We're going to start with number 1. From Scotty McLean and Neil McDowell. Whatever happened to that nice young Eddie?
Nice, yeah.
The bad ones are Rich Dixon's, the good ones are mine. Number 2. Dear Eddie, never heard of you, but I think you'll have a lot of time to play together soon, Donald Trump. Oh. Listen to you, Blaze. And Reed and I were supposed to bring up the plaques at the card room. Senior, super senior.
Yeah.
Club champ, multiples. Dear Eddie, give one for the Gipper, Ron Reagan. And now we go back a ways.
Junior's dead.
We're going back a ways. Oh, Eddie, these are heaven sent. These are heaven sent. We got a few more. Dear Eddie, thanks for showing me all the booze joints where the Catholic girls live in San Francisco, and caddying for me, Walter Hagen.
I hope that's it.
The good stuff's coming, Eddie. Dear Eddie, thanks for that whole kite and key thing, Ben Franklin.
Are you alive?
Yeah. I had to find number five. I revised him several times.
I'm saving the
good stuff, Eddie. Dear Edward, thank you for making all the road signs along my trip on the Mission Trail. Blessings, Father Junipero Serra.
Yeah, baby!
This is a joint one. This is a joint one from all the way from Alexandria, Egypt. Dear Edward, you perfected your sand game here, Cleopatra and King Tut.
Yeah, I'm not done, Eddie.
I was hoping you wouldn't.
I'm filibustering, as Andrea says. Number seven, dear Eddie, I don't care what my husband and all his golf buddies and all those degenerate gambler friends of his say about you. I love you, Susan Boston, Holy Family Church, and the Lake Shastina Men's Club. Oh, yeah.
When I was playing, I played a lot with Eddie, and it was always a treat to be in his car.
That was 1922.
I preserved, you did.
When it happened one day, things were slow, and this is more of a serious moment, but Eddie and I got to talking about our past and what got us here. And what Eddie told me, I took to heart to this day. The best thing that ever happened in his life when he married her. At that time, I watched Eddie and Berline. They'd come to Mass, and I'd go to play golf, and I'd come out here to the club. And it was a blessing in disguise to see these people that were born on Siskiyou County. And we were very lucky to have them in Lake Shastina and the Holy Family Parish. And I truly, truly love both of you. Thank you. Thank you. I have to tell you a story.
You won't believe this.
I'm playing down at Pasatiempo on the first team. Smoking a big brown cigar, enjoying myself, and my friend says to me, "You know, Eddie, you look just like a movie star with that cigar in your mouth." And I said, "Who's that?"
I kind of perked up.
"Who's that?" He says, "Lassie, taking a shit."